This tutorial is brought to you by PhotoshopTalent.com. Hey there, and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Iceflow Studios. And in this tutorial, we're going to be taking a look at a de-aging process, showing you how to very quickly, very simply, effectively get rid of things like wrinkles on someone's face. In front of us, we have a photo of an elderly gentleman, and you can clearly tell that he has a lot of wrinkles on his face. And typically, wrinkles make somebody look older than they are. And I'm going to show you how to get rid of these wrinkles right now. Now, we're going to be using primarily the patch tool, as well as the clone stamp tool, and I've discussed these in previous tutorials, but I'm going to touch on them again to show you how this method works. So to access the patch tool, it's right over here, and you may see this right here. If you hold down your mouse button, you will get the patch tool. And the shortcut key is J. If you hold shift and press J, you can cycle through the different tools in that menu. So we're going to select our patch tool, and we're going to head over to his right eye, or that would be his left eye, our right, and very simply, just like the lasso tool, we're going to drag out the area that we want to fix, just like so. And you'll notice that we now have a selection. All we have to do now is move our mouse inside the selection, click and drag to a smooth area on his skin of probably a similar luminosity, and then let go. You'll notice that that area is now pretty smooth and the wrinkles are gone. Basically, what it did is it took the area that we're dragging on top of and it sampled it, and then it applies it on top of the selected area and smooths it out very nicely. Now, it's not perfect, so we can grab something like our clone stamp and just fix up the areas that it may not have nicely blended. And then we can grab our patch tool once again and start getting rid of the areas like this. And I suggest doing it in very small chunks, because if you grab a big chunk of wrinkles and then drag it, you may not have room to drag it to a new area and it may not blend that nicely. So do it in small chunks, it'll look a lot better in the long run. So just go around his face, get rid of the wrinkles just like so. I'm doing a very sloppy job, obviously you will do it a lot nicer. Then you can grab this clone stamp and fix the areas that are looking a little bit rough. And we can go over to this area here, fix this wrinkle, drag it up, very quickly fix this one, head over to his left eye or his right eye, grab this, drag it down. And it's very, very simple. Now that one probably didn't work that great. Can even drag it down here if we wanted to. And it's looking a lot better. Obviously there are some areas that we need to fix with our clone stamp tool, but if we look at the before and then our after, there's definitely a huge difference in how he looks. He looks a lot younger. And if we continue to go around his face and get rid of all the wrinkles and fix all of the blemishes, he will look a lot younger than he is. And then you can go in and grab like an airbrush and then smooth out his skin a little bit. There are many ways of smoothing out someone's skin, but I'm here to focus on the wrinkles and make somebody look older in a pretty natural way. So we discussed the patch tool and we touched on the clone stamp tool in this tutorial. The patch tool is great for getting rid of small to somewhat big blemishes. So I hope you apply this to your projects. Make your parents look young if you want. Don't insult them though. Don't do that. You'll get smacked. Anyways, I hope you learned something. If you're on YouTube, rate the video, comment the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And until next time, this is Howard from Iceflow Studios. Take care.